In this video, we are going to create a presentation file in Autodesk Inventor in order to create an animated exploded assembly. First, of course, I need to have an assembly, and then I can create a presentation file. So I will select New. Then, in my case, I'm doing a metric assembly, so I'll choose the standard millimeter.ipn file for presentation. As soon as you create the presentation, Inventor is going to ask you to select an assembly. I'll select my assembly, then click Open. Let's look at the presentation user interface for just a moment. Of course, we have our window where we can see our assembly. We also have our model browser. In this case, it shows us a scene and the assembly and all the parts that comprise the assembly. The browser can be a convenient way to select objects rather than picking them on screen. At the top, in the ribbon, we have some tools for creating our exploded view. At the bottom, we have our storyboard. This is going to be our timeline where we set up our exploded view animation. On the right side, we have the snapshot views where we can create snapshot images of our exploded assembly. Before exploding my assembly, I am going to set my initial camera view. I'm going to do that by using this section down here in the storyboard, which is called the scratch zone. Here is my time slider where I can go to any time on the storyboard. I'm going to drag it into the scratch zone to set my initial view. I'm going to rotate my screen to get this from a different angle. I can use my view cube as well. I can also zoom in and out as needed. Knowing that I'm going to explode this, I am going to go ahead and zoom out a little bit on this assembly. Then I'm going to come up to the ribbon and select Capture Camera. Next, I'm going to start creating my exploded assembly. I'm going to begin by using the Tweak Components tool. With this tool, I can select one or more objects that I want to move in the exploded assembly. In my case, I want to move these four fasteners at the same time, so I'm going to go ahead and hold Control and select them all. It's going to be easier for me to select them from the model browser, so I'll go ahead and select the four components there using the Control key. As you can see, the mini toolbar opens up, and you can see some of the choices that I have. I can move or rotate objects. I can change the selection priority. For example, if I want to be able to pick individual parts or sub-assemblies. I can adjust this widget on screen to help me control the direction that I tweak things. As you can see, my origin over here does not match up with the component origin. Sometimes it makes more sense to leave the triad on the individual component. For example, if I wanted to rotate this component, I want it to rotate around this axis here. Other times it might make more sense to use the world triad since we have our X, Y, and Z directions already defined. So I'll select this dropdown and select world. As you can see, the widget adjusts to match the world triad. Next, I can decide if I want to display trails. Trails are lines that just simply indicate the direction things move. You can see some of the choices here. I can turn it off completely, all components, all parts, or just a single trail. Finally, I can control the time that it takes to explode these components. I want to bring these four fasteners 75 millimeters up, so I'm going to click and drag this arrow up, and then I can enter in the value here in the Z box. Then I can go ahead and click the checkbox to finish. Let's take a closer look at our storyboard. We can see the components that have been tweaked and the time frame for each of these. In each of these cases, it was 2.5 seconds. I can return this animation to the beginning and click play and watch all four explode at the same time in the duration of 2.5 seconds. You can adjust the timing several different ways. I can select one of these tweaks, right click and edit time, and adjust the value here. So let's say we want to go 3 seconds instead. You'll notice now that if I click play, one takes a little longer than the others. I can double click on one of the tweaks here and adjust the time there. I can also click and drag their edges to change the length of time as well. In addition, I can move these around. They don't have to go at the same time. I can stagger them if I want, or make them go one right after the other. Now you'll see that as I play, when one gets midway through, the next one will begin. I'll go ahead and return these all back to the beginning. I'm going to continue adding tweaks to components. I'm going to select this button here to move to the end of the timeline. And upon further review, since I'm going to explode these other parts, I actually want my fasteners to go up higher. Therefore, I'll right-click on any one of the tweaks here in the timeline and select Edit Tweak. Then I can go ahead and adjust the value as needed. We'll say 140 millimeters instead. And we can see the updated version. I will continue tweaking components. I'll go ahead and select this bracket and bring it out to the side 175 millimeters. Next, I'm going to bring the wheel out, but I'm going to give it three actions. I'm going to have it move in the X direction, then in the Z, and then rotate. So I'll select Tweak Components, then the wheel. I'll drag the arrow in the X direction, and I'll bring it out negative 110 millimeters here. I don't want to click Finish, though. That will stop the tweak. I just want to go ahead and add in my next tweak. So I'll select the Z arrow and drag it up negative 120 in this direction. Then I want to rotate it, so I'll select the Rotate option here. Then select which axis I want to rotate around. So I want it to rotate this direction 90 degrees. Then I'll select Finish. In my timeline, I'll move to right before the wheel moves and click Play so we can see the action here. We can see it moves out in the X direction, then up in the Z, and then it rotates. In my storyboard, I can expand the wheel and I can see each individual tweak. This will allow me to modify the times, but also I can have the tweaks take place at the same time. So maybe I want it to rotate as it is moving. So let's see that again. We'll see it go out in the X, then as it goes up, it's also going to rotate. I'm going to add a couple more tweaks to finish this presentation. I'll go ahead and bring the axle out here in the X direction, 110 millimeters. As you can see, positive 110 is going the wrong way, so I'm going to set that to negative 110. Then I will go ahead and have this bracket move out 110 millimeters. And then finally, I'll take the plate and bring it down. We'll say negative 80. And once again, I can modify the timeline in several different ways. I can adjust times. I can group things together. So let's say I'm going to have these last two actions work at the same time. We'll see the plate and the bracket explode together. We can incorporate some visual changes. If I no longer want to show the tweaks, I can right-click on the Tweak folder here and hide all trails. I can click the plus next to it and I can see each individual tweak. So this is another way I can access each one. We can also adjust the visibility of components. So for example, let's say that after these four fasteners come up, we want them to disappear from the screen. I'm going to move to the 3 second mark here where the tweak is completed. Then I will select the four fasteners, once again holding Control to do so. Then in the ribbon, I will select Opacity. I'm going to have to break from the design view, so I'll select Break. Then I can adjust how opaque these components are, so I can bring them all the way down to zero to make them invisible. Then click Finish. I'll return to the beginning here and click Play, and we'll see them explode and then they'll instantly disappear. So instead, I would like those to fade out. So I'll go ahead and expand one of these fasteners here, and here we can see where it's going to go invisible. I'm going to double click on this component here, and instead of it going away instantly, I'm going to change it to duration. I can give it a start time, a length, and or an end time. So I'll adjust the start time to 2.5 seconds, and I will make this last 1 second. Now, as I return to the beginning and play, we'll see one of these fasteners is going to fade away instead of disappearing. You can see that one right there. So obviously, I can go ahead and apply the same steps to the other fasteners to get them to do the same thing. I'm going to finish my animation with a rotation. So I'm just simply going to go to the end of my timeline, make a change to my view. You can just manually rotate or you can use the view cube here. Then, just like we did at the very beginning, I'm going to capture the camera. You can see a camera has been added here at the end, and now as it gets towards the end of the timeline, as it's pulling those last two pieces apart, you can see that the camera is going to rotate. I can also adjust the display style of this presentation. In order to do so, I have to go back to the scratch section here at the beginning and set it from the start. So now I can select the View tab. I can add in shadows if I would like. I can choose several different types of shadows in here. I can also change the visual style. Maybe I'll go with technical illustration this time instead. Finally, I can export this to a video. I'll return to the Presentation tab, and in the Publish panel, select Video. I'll select the current storyboard here if necessary. Note that this can also be reversed, so if I've created an exploded assembly and I want it to go backwards to show how something comes together, I can do that. I can select my window size. I will accept the current size here. Then finally give it a name and a location to save and a file type. There's a couple of different choices here. Then I will simply click OK and it will generate a video for me. In the interest of time, I've already generated that video and now you can see that I can click play and see the full video of my animated exploded assembly. That concludes this look at creating presentations and animated exploded assemblies in Autodesk Inventor.